Clay, Father, why are you interfering?
This is none of the church's business.
It's the widow's field.
No, it's my field. I dug that field with my bare hands. It's my child. I nursed it. I gave it everything it wants. You want to take that field away from me now? And in the sight of God, I can't let you do it.
Can't you find another field?
Another field? Another field? Don't you understand? Those hands, them rocks. I made it was dead, it was a dead thing, and I made a living thing out of it.
This is the widow's field. That's the law, the common law.
There's another law. Karma stronger than the common law.
What's that?
The law of the land. When I was a boy, younger than time there, the land couldn't support my brothers and sisters. So it was the emigration ship for the lot of them. I was the only one left, the heir. Neighbours were scarce. So my father and I, we had our breakfast, our dinner, and our tea in that field. My mother brought us our meals. One day my father sensed a drop of rain in the air. And my mother helped us bring in the hay. On the third day, I was at the top of the field, my mother was at the bottom. And I seen her fall back, keel over, so to speak. I called my father, I ran to my mother. My father, he knew she was dying. He read an act of contrition in her ear, asked God to forgive her sins, and he looked at me and he said, fetch a priest. Fetch a priest. I said to my father, let's bring in the hay first. My father looked at me with tears of pride in his eye. He knew I'd take care of the land. And if you think I'm going to face my mother in hell or in heaven without that field, you've another thing coming. No collar. No priest, no uniform, or no weapon will stand in my way of getting that field.